over here, but we are live back at Gender King Inn after the live air meet here. We are up next with the Red Bull Aerobatic team. This is an incredible display and one of only a couple teams, especially RC teams in the world that are allowed to use the Red Bull namesake professionally, right? You can have your own Red Bull scheme, but these guys are rocking the Red Bull name officially.
Yeah, Red Bull are super strict about what they put the name to. We know that as a company. We've worked with them with color schemes on cars and airplanes.
Yep.
And yeah, these guys are one of only two a team of three, this particular one, father and son, and Tim Stadler. For me, the best, without question of a doubt, aerobatic, air show display team anywhere in the world. From their presentation, their professionalism, their flying skill, the models, even their trailer, dude, is like the best. I showed you yesterday.
I couldn't believe that. I mean, the airplane's loaded automatically. Well, you have to put them on the tray, but the trailer is an automatic trailer where the airplanes actually load in and somehow don't hit each other.
But if anyone's listening and is interested, go on the Red Bull Aerobatic Team's Facebook page and you'll get to see a video of it. Yeah, these guys are to another level. We've used this phrase enough, but if we say the other guys are to another, guys are another two levels up. They live and breathe this stuff. I followed them for a long time and watched them progress. It was originally just the Fuchs father and son, and then Tim came along and added another set of world-class thumbs to the equation. Their models, the presentation, they're perfect. I mean, that thing you're looking at, oh, ultimate, probably done 1,000 flights. Thing looks newer than I can get an airplane straight before its first flight. So, yeah, it's incredible.
Yeah, it looks so good together. You talk about precision. They're flying extremely close together. I'm able to watch the YouTube stream. I know I'm delayed on the view because our feed's down here, but I mean that's an incredibly tight formation. It's big old airplanes.
Now, flying by yourself, relatively easy. Flying formation with two is really difficult. Flying formation with any more than two just increases the difficulty of an exponential of six, in my opinion. Because you're formating on one guy and you think, okay, I'm close, I'm far. Then you've got this other guy who's got to formate on you. So if you go out, he goes out even further. So yeah, to see these guys pull off the precision that they do as they do it. These are genuine kits. These are old school. Build them all yourself, cover them, and then paint them. A lot of work. These aren't ARTFs that are disposable by any means. You know, the highest value component in this airplane is the labor.
Yeah, agreed. A little opposing pass action, as you're getting to see there with smoke on. Yeah, every year these guys are at air meet. I know. Not every single pilot has been to air meet with all three of these airplanes, especially not the Dash 300, but and Tim Stadler just putting on one of the best shows in model aviation right now.
Posing cars.
Looks like we got our feedback alley, so that's nice.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Looking at my screen.
More live with the commentation. There's the opposing triple pass.
Yeah, Tim came to Joe Knoll probably 6 years ago, our biggest air show in the US. And yeah, he didn't come, unfortunately, with the rest of the team. He came as a solo act, but with a big biplane, a Pitts Challenger, if I remember rightly. Yeah, just wiped the show out, stopped everyone dead with his low-level, precise air show style flying. Look at that roll. It's like they're on the same radio.
Yeah,
it's frustrating, you know. That was a perfect roll rate at perfectly timed. It's like one dude just pushed the aileron and all three went.
I can assure you it's not happening.
No. Yeah.
And they even have like the lead playing. I mean, that's the stuff is all. These stuff you see in real air shows, that level of perfection.
Yeah.
And these guys are all doing it from the ground.
Tim is the guy there facing you. Robert and Sebastian, father and son, are the ones to the left, looking the opposite way. Very little communication, if you look.
Yeah.
That's
how many times they've practiced this.
I was going to say, that's either they're very lucky.
No, they're not.
Or they're very, very well rehearsed.
Very well rehearsed, yeah. Especially
that join
even,
up move,
yeah, the joining up and the solo acts. I mean, this is all stuff you would see in full-scale aviation, having that coordination in the model, I just is unbelievably difficult.
I would bet a decent meal that they've done this not in the hundreds, but in the thousands of times. You know, this exact flight with these airplanes. I watched on their Facebook page the rehearsal for ME last weekend. Yeah. You know, they actually went out and said, right, we know everything's working, but it doesn't matter. We're still going to go and do a full weekend of pre-air meet test flying with all the aircraft and just rigging them, Steve. I know you're talking probably 2-3 hours of three guys working nonstop to rig the aircraft from trailer ready to fly by the time you've assembled, charged, fuel, pre-flight and so forth. So they did all of that the weekend before air meet to make sure.
Wow, absolutely
incredible.
That's commitment. I mean, that takes time, effort, and just passion.
Professionalism for me as well, I think, is a word that is, again, I just hope they got it. They lucked out on the first one, but they just nailed that half roll again perfectly.
Yeah,
professionalism is a word that we I think we overlook because this is a hobby.
Yeah.
These guys are professionals. They you know, don't look at it as a hobby. They're representing Horizon. They're representing Red Bull, both industry leaders.
Wow.
And they act accordingly.
Even do a full kind of pull up and do a quick yaw turn. That was perfect. Here we go again. In case you missed it the first time, there it is again.
I think it's more to prove that it wasn't luck as well.
All down to a nice high alpha.
Probably we torque rolling now, so they'll probably pop up in front of the smoke on, enter the torque roll. Often gets very smoky at this stage.
There it is. Oh, yeah, that's close.
Oh, just to put it into context as well, even though I said the labor is the most expensive part of what you're seeing, there's still $15,000 per airplane right there. So times that by three, that's a lot of money. So yeah, it's probably Tim, I'm guessing, now into the low rollers, the inverted, the rolling Harrier segment. That, to put it into context, is about half a second away from being worthless. Mm-hmm. One small mistake at
one
that
small
height,
thumb maneuver away.
You haven't got the height to trade for anything other than a bag of broken ultimates.
Oh, they do it well. They do it well. And there's definitely no room for error, but I'd seen the errors coming out of these guys.
I'm looking forward to later on because these guys haven't just bought these ultimates, they've bought three other spectacular.
And they're not even on the runway yet.
They're too big. Nobody could get past if they put the other three aircraft on the runway.
And those haven't been seen really before.
First time ever. World premiere
at
Air Meet.
You guys are
going
to see the world premiere at Air Meet with three more aircraft later on from the same team, which are a lot bigger.
Yes. I think if you joined all of the Ultimates together, they still wouldn't be as long as one of the aircraft that the Red Bull team are flying later on. So, yeah, stay tuned. I'm not going to say what they are. We're going to keep you hanging on in suspense because it's well. We got to see them out on the runway yesterday, and it was, I mean, one of these aircraft would be showstopper, right?
Mm-hmm.
Two would be industry first, never heard of. Who's crazy enough to do that? Just for giggles, these guys decided, third one.
You gotta have three, that makes it cooler. Yeah. And they all fit in the same trailer, which is mind-blowing.
Yeah,
it's...
I keep asking if they'll take me on as a team member, just polish the tires, or I just fill the airplanes up, I'll be happy.
You could bring beer to them maybe after the show.
They don't drink beer, it's Red Bull team, Steve, come on.
You can bring a Red Bull, they have plenty of Red Bull.
There you go.
I'm sure they have plenty of Red Bull. The last time I was at a Red Bull hangar with Chuck Aaron, there was pallets of Red Bull, so I know these guys are well stocked by their sponsor.
Good.
Oh man, these... the skies are looking really, really interesting out there. Those thunderstorms passed.
Better than they did an hour ago.
Yeah, that's for sure. I'm glad to see some sun out there. I know it's towards the end of the afternoon. Here they come in, I believe, for a landing with smoke gone.
Yeah, inboard one. That one.
Yep, I would say inboard one as well.
I'm going to bet that was Tim. Not saying he's my favorite or anything, but Tim's my favorite.
yeah, that is Tim. See, yeah. It says his name right there on the inside. Yeah.
No disrespect to Robert and Sebastian. I should really be playing Robert.
Tim's on the middle.
Is he?
I was Tim in the middle. Because
I hope it's Robert. That's the dad. He's the one that would take me on as a
there you go.
Filler-upper.
There you go.